Hey guys, Titanium Turbo Ranger, finally back with another review. I apologize, it's taken me as long as it has. I'm really busy with school, college applications, work, things of that nature. I had family visit from Europe for a couple weeks. But I have been buying, I'm working on some secret projects. But let's get right to it today. This is the Super Zeo Megazord. I bought this guy off of eBay for $29.50 with free shipping. Nice deal on this thing because it's old. And it's in really good condition. I mean, the only thing I had a problem with were tiny little bits of scuff right on this little piece on the Red Zord, which I took care of because I'm like that. And otherwise, everything else is in really good condition. The backstory of this guy is after the Golden Powers, after the Gold Ranger powers were transferred to Jason, Trey of Triforia went back to his home planet because he was split up into three different beings, I guess you could say, and he had to go back to unite himself, but he gave the gold powers to Jason to preserve them, and he gave the Rangers the Super Zeo gems, one for every single Zord, as a gift, and they just set a formed out in the middle of nowhere, and it was good because King Mondo released an army of monsters to combat the Rangers. So they had an army of Zords to tackle him right back.
The Super Zeo Gems. I was certain that they were lost forever. This is indeed a great gift.
Jason, use the power from your golden staff to bring the jewels to life. Take care of the golden power. It is our hope that someday we will reclaim it.
You can count on me, guys.
The Super Zeo Zords are forming. You must get to them.
Let's go.
I really like this guy. A lot of hatred goes to this guy. Oh, it looks stupid. It looks like, you know, a bunch of little kids' toys that you put together. You know how you have those little cubes where the kids put the shapes in? I kind of like it. I think the transformation is really weird. I mean, from how they go from this to a gigantic Megazord, because it is big. It's about 14 inches tall. The guy is almost as big as Mega Tigerzord. A Mega Tigerzord is huge. Let's go ahead and get right to the transformation, and I will talk about it from there. Here's Ranger Pink. Pull those in half. As you can see, it's just a little clip system. Clip here, pull it apart. These clips will fold down like this, and the panel will lock in, so the clips go away, so you have a flat surface, and her head will pop right in like that. Then you will take it from right here. This will fold down like this, and then this will fold into that. Then you take that, and you pop that in. There's your foot. Same for the other one. Pop this up, like that, and then pop this down and in. Pretty simple. I like everything about hers, except the fact that it's chrome on one side, and on the other side it's gray, but they're cheap when it comes to paint, not much you can do about it. Next is Ranger Green. Ranger Green was actually kind of cool, because in the individual Zord battles, he fought underwater. That was sweet. Just go ahead and pop this off. Then you're going to take his head. One thing about him, one of the cons of him, is these don't really lock in too well. The other Zords tend to lock in a lot better than his, but not too bad. That'll pull out and go into the back. Then his head will pop up and go into a socket in the side. And his feet are really cool. I like this. You take his foot and you flip it over like this. And then you're going to go ahead and you're going to flip it over again. And his foot will literally fold in like that. See how it was? It's fully extended, and you fold this in, and then this went in here. And that locks in like that. Same thing with the other side. Just put the arm in the back. His panel over here, no head though, so just pop this over. Same thing with the foot, just turn this in, flip it around again. You got these two little hooks right here, and these will attach right here in the back to the Pink Ranger Zord. There we go. That's what you get. Blue probably has the widest range of transformation. First thing you want to do is put his arms in the back. Put his other arm in the back. And then we go ahead and pop this up and pop that up. Then we're going to go ahead and flip these around. And you're going to want him to get him right out here. And then you're going to either want to put his head in, because if you leave it out, it's going to look like, you know, he has a little package down there. And that'll look like that. You're going to flip that around, and these will fit right down into here. And that just sort of clips in there. It's really secure. I'm surprised. The only thing that I think they needed to work on was this right here. This joint is not the best, but it holds up okay. Once the weight's on top of it, it's fine. Pull that right in there, and that's it. Here we go, the red one. I like the red one the best. I mean, they could all fly. They had really great abilities. I think that they look great, but red was definitely my favorite, not to mention gigantic Tommy fan. Tommy Oliver is my hero.
He is the Sky Ranger! Let's go!
Show he's down here somewhere.